It was the second police station to be bombed inside a week, and confirmation of a new IRA campaign to wreck all IUC bases. Tarpaulins covered the spots where two policemen were shot dead as they opened the main gate for one of them to go home. In this small substation in the middle of a Catholic and Protestant village, only five men were on duty. The three remaining inside escaped as one gunman gave covering fire and two others carried a bomb in a beer keg into the hallway. After an explosion which destroyed the station, local politicians said it was all linked to the Anglo-Irish initiative.
The IRA are cock-a-hoop. They believe that Mrs. Thatcher has surrendered to them. They believe the SDLP have ridden on their backs. As far as the unionists are concerned, we now believe that Mrs. Thatcher and the IRA are riding on their backs.
I think I stated very, very clearly that when a majority of people wanted Irish unity, legislation would be introduced to bring about Irish unity. I don't think that there's any further cause for violence. I believe that the people who have performed these deeds are partitionists, have a partitionist mentality, and the last thing they want to see is true Irish unity.
As with the attack which wrecked Tomb Bridge RUC station 3 days ago, the IRA have warned that anyone carrying out repair work to police stations will be a legitimate target. That threat has also stopped work at a new prison being built at McGabry near Lisburn. In all, more than 1,000 construction workers have been laid off.